turtles go back around 230 million years. Sea turtles go back around 110 million years. And you know, while I'm happy to report that we've had a really big nesting year this year and last year, their numbers are still depleted from what they've been historically. So we're not looking at a species that's out of the woods yet. I'm Jeanette Wyneken. I'm a professor at Florida Atlantic University in Boca Raton, Florida. We're on the southeast coast of Florida, and we're in the heart of prime sea turtle nesting area. Morning, guys. For our 5 miles of beach, you know, we're getting a little over 1,000 nests. The turtles use this beach. They use it a lot. And the reason why Boca Raton seems special is both its proximity to major currents, and the major current seems to be the Gulf Stream. And because of the way the land has been managed, there's a lot of dark silhouettes at night. The female turtles are attracted to dark silhouettes. And the babies, when they come out of the nest, flee tall, dark silhouettes. That's one of the major cues that guides the hatchlings to the water. So a typical loggerhead down here in southern Florida is producing about 105 eggs. If a female nests five times 105, if my math is good today, should be 525 eggs. So we go back to that female, she'll have to nest over 10 nesting seasons, which is about in the case of a loggerhead, a 20 or 30 year period, just to replace herself and maybe one mate. If you do a back of the envelope calculation, we're looking at about 1 in 7,000 making it to adulthood. When we think about the biology of the animal, you know, the loggerhead has been around for around 60 million years. There have been a lot of climatic changes during that time, and very few of them have occurred at this rate. It changes where the droughts occur, it changes where the heavy rainfall events occur, it changes where major tropical storms occur and the sizes of the tropical storms. The shifting climate is shifting turtles as well.
So we survey the beach for nests that are at risk of being washed out, so nests that are close to the high tide line. And I relocate those nests in my study site. My name is Alex Lolivar, and I'm a PhD student at Florida Atlantic University. And what I do is I divide the nest into two smaller nests. And I put one half in a dry zone that doesn't get any sprinkling, so regular sprinkling at all. And then the other half goes in a wetter zone that gets regular sprinkling daily.
Now, one of the things that we've discovered is when there's major rainfall events or major storm surge events, that we can see the changes in the temperature in the nest. So the reason why the temperature matters is because sea turtles have environmentally determined sex. They don't have an X or Y chromosome. They have a sex that's defined during development by the incubation environment. And in general, we have highly biased sex ratios where female bias is common. If the sand absorbs more heat, we're going to push that female bias, which we know is really common down here, to an even more extreme situation. We care about the moisture for a whole bunch of reasons, and not the least of which is that we've identified that moist nests are producing more males. And what we were finding is that those drought years gave us up to 100% females in our samples, and that's a little alarming. Let's take that same turtle and her nesting over 20 years, so that's 10 nesting events. If five of those, everything gets wiped out by storms, and five of those are drought years where turtle production is low and it's so hot that everything that comes out of the nest is a female, wow, as long as they can find a date, they've got a future. But if there aren't enough males out there, then there's a problem. And that's important again because with changing climates, we're going to see drought areas. You think about these animals that have, through their evolutionary history, they've nested on peninsulas, they've nested on islands, So they have to have ways of compensating. And one of the ways they compensate is they don't nest every year. So if they have a bad year in their reproductive life, 1 year may not be a big deal. And that resiliency is one of the features that I think is an important one. You know, they've been through some climate changes, but we hope this climate changing event is not one that they can't recover from, that they can't compensate for. And if it is so bad that they can't compensate, that's a pretty dire statement, not only for the turtles, but for us.